The super senses of animals. The objectives of this video are A. To know about the sense organs of wild animals. B. To know interesting facts about wild animals. C. To know about the forest and its conservation. Children, get up, it's morning. Don't you have to go to visit Nani Ma?
Yes, Mother. We have to go.
Ramesh Kaka is about to come to drop you to Nani's village. Hurry up and get ready. I shall pack some food for the way.
Look, Ramesh Kaka is here. Let's go, Bholu.
Take care of yourself, children, and gather a lot of information about your homework from Nani.
Bholu, look at the colorful kites.
Ramesh Kaka, do these birds like the colors of these colorful kites?
Meenu, birds cannot see all the colors. Only human beings have the ability to see all the colors. Some living creatures can see only black and white. The animals who are awake at daytime can see a few colors, but the ones who are awake at night can see only black and white.
Is it, Kaka?
Yes, children. This is a fact.
Thank you, Kaka. You gave us an important information. Kaka, how much more time will it take to reach Nani's village?
We are almost there.
Oh, is it you, Meenu and Bholu? How are you, my kids?
We are fine, Nani. How are you? Our summer holidays have started and we thought of visiting you.
Let's go inside, children. And then let's talk at ease.
Nani, do you know we have to do a very interesting homework for the summer holidays? Our headmaster, sir, has asked us to research on the sense organs of animals and birds. We thought, since you live near the jungle and you are the best storehouse of information on this topic, so we decided to learn from you. Did we do the right thing, Nani Ma?
Yes, Bholu, you did the right thing. Let us eat something first and then you both tell me about what you already know about the topic of research. All right, children, now tell me about what you know about the sense organs of animals and birds.
Nani, you know, yesterday an eagle picked a roti from my plate and flew away. Didi told me about its sharp eyesight. And Nani, these ants, they walk in such a straight line. The children of my class never walk in a line, especially Munnu. He always breaks the line. Nani, on the way to your home, Ramesh Kaka told us about the ability of animals and birds to distinguish colors. It was an important information.
Excellent job, children. You both have a lot of information about animals around us. Now you eat something and take rest. Then let us go to the jungle and on the way, I shall tell you about sense organs of wild animals.
Look, Nani, Meenu, a crocodile. And look, another one.
Yes, do you know that animals like crocodiles, alligators that we see in summers go for hibernation?
Hibernation? What is that, Nani?
Children, Some animals go for long sleep in winters. That is known as hibernation. Like lizards are not seen in winters because they hibernate. Children, try and walk softly on dry leaves. Polu, because there could be snakes here.
Oh, snakes! Yes, they could hear us walking.
No, Polu. Snakes don't have ears.
What, Nani? Snakes don't have ears? Then how do they hear?
Due to the vibration of the sound, the snakes can make out the sounds.
Wow, what an interesting fact!
The three of them moved forward in the jungle and came across a herd of elephants. Snakes don't have ears, but due to the vibration of sounds, they understand the sound.
Look, Polu, a herd of elephants. They are huge. Just look at their big ears and long trunk.
Tell me one thing, Nani. Since elephants have such big ears, I'm sure they can hear very well.
Yes, Meenu. Elephants' ability to hear is amazing. They can hear sounds from up to 5 miles. And you must have observed that elephants keep moving their ears.
Yes, Nani, we have seen it. Is there a mystery in this too?
Elephants do this to keep themselves cool. You can say that elephants use their ears to fan themselves.
Amazing! I will definitely share this with my teacher in school.
Nani, aren't you scared of the wild animals?
No, Meenu. Animals are peace-loving creatures. The jungle is their home and we should not disrupt it. Animals are herbivores, carnivores, and some are omnivores. However, they reside deep in the jungle.
What? Man-eaters? Nani, will we be able to spot a tiger?
Looks difficult, Bholu. Firstly, tigers live deep in the jungle. And secondly, man for his own selfish reasons has killed a lot of tigers. Therefore, very few tigers are left.
Is it, Nani?
Yes, children. But I shall tell you about the sense organs of the tiger. Let's sit under the shade of the tree. Children, the tiger is a very clever animal. Come, I shall tell you about the sense organs of the tiger. A tiger's sight is very strong. It is 6 times stronger than man. The whiskers of a tiger are very sensitive. They allow him to spot its prey at night. The tiger's sense of hearing is very strong. Tigers make various types of sounds. Its roar can be heard up to 3 kilometers away. Tigers are very territorial. They can demarcate their territory with the help of the smell of their urine.
Yes, it's majestic.
Right, children. But man in his selfishness is killing tigers and other his selfishness and cutting forests too.
Why does man kill and poach the wild animals, Nani?
For the tiger's skin, the elephant's tusks, the snake's skin, and various other body parts of other animals. And for wood, man is cutting down forests. Think about the wild animals, children. If we cut down trees, we are destroying their home.
This is a very serious problem. If someone destroys our home, where will we live? These animals are speechless and we are destroying their homes for our selfish reasons.
Children, Think and tell us about how can we save forests.
Nani, isn't the government doing something about it?
Very good question, Bholu. Our government has established several national parks where wild animals can live in their natural habitat, like Jim Corbett in Uttarakhand for tigers, Kaziranga in Assam for the rhinoceros. And there are laws for poaching of animals too. But we all also have to contribute towards saving wildlife and our forests.
Yes, Nani, my teacher has also told us about the importance of forests. Nani, we will share this important information with our friends, and together we shall try and save wildlife and the forests.
Great job, children. If all of us try and take initiative, then we can save our wildlife.
Friends, you also take this pledge with us that together we all will try and save our forests and wildlife.
So children, I hope you collected a lot of information about the sense organs of wild animals. Now remember all the information and present a wonderful homework to your headmaster.
Yes, Nani. You have given us very meaningful information and we will complete our assignment well. Yes, Nani. Thank you.
Children, it's almost evening. Let's walk back towards home.
Friends, so this is how Bholu and Meenu gathered information about the sense organs of wild animals. We hope you all have also learnt with us. We shall meet soon with our next video. Till then, keep researching on the sense organs of animals and birds.